Hi, this is Freddy from Switzerland, and I'm coming at you with another review. So, here is the review that I have promised you for a long time. It's the review of the Walther lever action, as you can see it here. Air rifle, a CO2 air rifle that shoots 4.5 mm pellets. In the box, there comes a 1 88 gram CO2 cartridge, like this here. This one is already used. 2 8-shot magazines like this one here. This one is already loaded. A screwdriver to unscrew the back cap right here. And special pliers to screw in your cartridge, the last millimeters. I also have here on the table two different kinds of pellets or ammunition. This one is the Gecko ammo, very cheap and also quite well made and nice for shooting paper and stuff like that. The other ammunition is Stoker X-Field, as you see here. This is a little more heavier and a little more expensive ammunition, which is nice because I'm shooting steel targets, which I'll show you in photos in this video. So they are very nice for shooting steel targets. This also works, but they do a little bit better. Velocity out of this gun is 175 meters per second. So it's not really for hunting small game or something like that. It's just a fun plinking gun for steel targets or for paper. Now I give you a little close up of the gun. You see here, I got the long barreled version with a 19 inch barrel. And also the Wells Fargo finish, which is this golden copper like on the receiver here. And it's actually built after the 1897 Winchester lever action rifle. And you see here the other side of the Wells Fargo finish with this motif on there. And the sights are iron sights, but they are made out of plastic and they are adjustable for elevation and windage on the front blade. The whole gun is made out of wood, stock and forend, copper on this finish right here, and the rest is steel, also barrel and the tube magazine, which is not a real tube magazine, but it's made out of steel. Also the lever, trigger, hammer, everything is made out of steel. The only things that are made out of plastic is the buttstock. It's made out of plastic. Then the sides, as I said, and this connective things here. These are plastic too. So, now you may be wondering how you load this gun up, because you know it doesn't have the tube magazine like the real gun. This is quite well done, because I see here, there would you put your normal 30-30 or 44 mag or something like that, and now you push it just down and out comes the magazine, the rotary magazine here. Now you can take it out and put some pellets in there, put it back in, close it, cycle the lever, and now you're good to go if you have a cartridge in the buttstock. So that's how you load the gun. I think it's very well done and very easy to do. It's nice for a fast reload. So now I'm going to show you how you put in the 88 gram CO2 cartridge, and actually this is the newer model of this gun because the older one did not use these 88 gram CO2 cartridges. It used two 12 gram CO2 cartridges with a slightly different mounting method. But I think these ones are quite good because you have a lot more CO2, so they last for about 450 to 500 shots. But they are quite expensive because these are proprietary for CO2 guns and not used in some kitchen stuff like the 12 gram CO2 cartridges. So to load your lever action with CO2, you can see here there is a little screw, and you unscrew this one with the screwdriver that comes with it. So you take this here, screw it, the butt stock comes off, and in here there is a little hole. Maybe you can see here, and there goes your CO2 cartridge. So you take it, slam it in there, screw it in with your fingers, at first, and for the last millimeters you take your pliers and screw it in there. So I'm not going to do this because I can't shoot outside if it's very cold, because then the cartridges do not have the proper pressure and so they do not work. So if you have a CO2 rifle or pistol, you know what I'm talking about. That's a little weakness of the CO2 design, because with a normal air gun with a spring or something, you can shoot in every condition, but with CO2 guns you have to have a little bit of warmth, so it has to be like 15 degrees Celsius that you can use your gun and shoot with it properly. So what I like about this gun especially is how very well it's made. It's very nice fit and finish, very great materials are used. What I don't like about this model is that the buttstock, as you can see, made out of plastic, is very wide. It's quite big. On the older models, this was not as big as this one. So this has to do with the incorporation of the long 88 gram CO2 cartridge, but that's for the looks, it's not that great. But other than that, I really like it. It's quite accurate, about 20 meters. You can hit my steel targets. And yes, although it's a quite expensive air gun, it cost me about 400 Swiss francs with shipping. I bought it in Germany. But you get a gun that is very much like the copied Winchester model in weight, in size, in lever action, in trigger pull. It's everything is very, very, very resemblant of the real gun. And I always wanted a lever action, but something that I can shoot in my backyard. And in Switzerland, we cannot shoot 22s in the backyard, so I got this CO2 rifle, and I'm quite happy with it, and I'm maybe going to buy a real lever action in 44 mag or 357 mag or something like that when time goes on. But for now I'm quite happy with my purchase, and I hope you like this review. If you have any questions, please ask, and please comment, rate and subscribe.